In New Orleans, Louisiana, you can't walk five steps without seeing a great restaurant. But still, Tulane's hunger has not been curbed. The Green Wave, hungry for a home win and hoping they can deliver today. Time for ESPN's College Football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit will be on the call. Brad, take it away.
New Orleans, Louisiana, home of the famous French Quarter, the site for our football contest today. Hello, football fans. Brad Nessler here, along with Kirk Herbstreit in the booth and Aaron Andrews on the sidelines. Tulane has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. Singleton fields it at the one. Tackle made at the 27-yard line. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Spartans were ranked 15th. Their job, don't get caught napping. They did that and then some. They hope to move up in the polls next week. And for Eastern Michigan, they've lost two in a row. And for Maxwell, he finishes with a touchdown toss. Michigan State gets the W, 34-24.
For Ole Miss, Kirk, talk about this quarterback a little bit and how key he is to this offensive attack.
Well, these guys like to play under control. Lots of discipline and smart calls. You might see four passes in a row to guys at four different positions. And it's that willingness to spread the ball around that makes them so tough to contain. Got to admire the intensity that these linebackers bring to the table. As soon as he saw it was staying on the ground, he made a beeline for the ball carrier.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on their own 23. Wallace drops to throw. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
It's third down and 13 to go. Ball on the 23. The intensity of this place is increasing. Drops back to pass. Goes quick to the receiver and falls incomplete. So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Campbell is waiting for the snap. Tackle at midfield. So the opening drive failed to produce any points.
I'm sure the fans are thrilled to see their guys come up with an early stop in this game. Let's see if the offense can give them something else to get excited about now.
So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
Griffin, the ball carrier. And they get nice yardage on that run.
Gain 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on the 45-yard line. In the shotgun and five wideouts. He's going to try and scramble. He's tackled at the 40. He scrambles and picks up five. Third down and short. Ball on the 40.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Tulane could take the lead with this field goal. He gets it up, and he just didn't have the leg for this one. Tough break there for the kicking team. Still no score. The offense will start at the 40-yard line. He drops back. Brought down at about the 49.
Number 18 with the tackle at the 49-yard line. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Scott Scott on the give. Runs right for a nice gain. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really a nice read.
From the 45-yard line, first down. Zips it to the tight end. The 10. Touchdown, Mississippi.
It's got to take a really good ball fake here to get this safety to bite up. But he did a really good job, and with the safety out of position, they're able to get the football into the end zone.
Tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off.
Number 26, deep to the 10.
He's to the 10. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. They'll set up shop at the 20-yard line. So the run goes for a big first down.
The offensive line opened up some nice lanes to run through as well. Nice play.
First and 10. Ball on the 33. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. He scrambled. And he dives, and he's down. From their own 38-yard line, it's second down. They hand it off. He's at midfield. To the 10. Touchdown, Tulane.
That was simply sensational running, and it shows you what kinds of major things can happen when you have a good ground game.
Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. And he hits the PAT with a three-play, 80-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
You know, this offense right now is running the football when they want to, passing the football when they want to, they're having big plays pretty much at will anytime they want to come up with big plays. I just don't know if there's anything that this defense can do to stop him.
We got a tie game at 7-7. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. They punched it in for 6 on the last series. Can they do it again?
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
He drops back. Looks quick to his tight end, and he can't hang on.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. Fired quickly, and he's got his man. Tackle right around the 34.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. And it's going to be hard even to hear the snap count. This place is hopping. He's going to come up short. Good tackle.
Well, this is the kind of play you want to see if you're a defensive player, because not only is it a negative play, but this can really impact and affect the emotion of the game. Just looking down and looking at the energy on the field and even on the sidelines, you can see that the defense is fired up after that play.
Gets to about the 37-yard line. Take over at the 37. And he's stopped behind the line. Just nowhere for the ball carrier to go as the linebacker met him in the backfield.
Boy, what great play recognition by this linebacker. He saw the run was coming and he just shot through the gap and made a great tackle.
From their own 34-yard line, second down. He lost the ball, scooped up by the defense. And he's taken down right around the 36-yard line.
That just shows you how determined this defense is. Great play by the linebacker to come up with the ball after the fumble.
And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. He gets out to about the 35-yard line.
That's a gain of one. That brings up second and nine.
It's second and nine. Ball on the 35. To pass. And down he goes at the 30-yard line.
Number 18 on the tackle at the 30-yard line. That'll bring up third and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. The crowd is deafening. They'll make the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
He'll try to change the field position and especially not get it to the end zone. Hangs it up high. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. They'll go to work at the 20. Drops to throw on first down. Throws this one out to the left. He's to the 40. Great catch there before they can knock him out of bounds. The tight end came up with a nice catch that time.
Yeah, the big fella's pretty athletic for a tight end. And as a quarterback, it's always nice to have a big target like this to go to.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. He's back to pass here on first down.
Can't find anyone open.
Now he's going to run and watch out. And they make the stop around the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up second and 3.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Here we go.
Runs it right. Nice pickup. And he carried that one for a few yards.
You know, when you have a guy that can grab 5 yards or so consistently, it sure takes some of the pressure off the passing game.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on 34. And they'll run him again. Nice run, and he's brought down. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Man, it's an offensive lineman. This is the worst thing that you want to see, is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of it.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. And a quick throw. And he's tackled around the 25-yard line. It's going to be fourth and inches after that long pickup on third down.
Boy, what a throw by the quarterback. Almost equally excellent catch by the receiver, but the defense topped them both by coming up with a stop.
We've played one. We're even at seven in this one. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. He gets hit out of bounds at the 22-yard line. This is the eighth play of this drive. Again, he'll get the call. Nice play to set up first and goal. First down. They're inside the five. Defense comes out in a 4-4. They need a big play here. They bring him down in the backfield.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the three. They're packed in tight on the line. Taken down just outside the goal line. A 2 yard run by the halfback.
That makes it third and goal.
The defense backed up into their own end zone. It's third and goal from the one. 4-4 defense trying to come up with a defensive stand here. And off touchdown. Tulane is up by six. And he adds the extra point. So a 10-play, 45-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. At the 40. He breaks away, and this could be six. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. That was some play by the special teams. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. He'll return it from the one. Tackle made at the 21. This drive will start at the 21-yard line. the 20.
That is a loss of 1 yard. That'll bring up second and 12.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. Griffin on the option left side. Tackle made around the 20-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
That makes it third and 11.
It's third down and 11 to go. Ball on their own 20. Throws left. The running back's got it. Brought down around the 35-yard line. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Tigers arrived today ranked number 7. Their steady climb in the polls they hope will continue today. Let's take yet another peek at this game. And for LSU, they're looking to win 2 in a row. The Tigers have the lead 14-7.
Well, it seems like every year we have one of those weekends where there's upset specials, and that one would be an upset. From their own 35-yard line, first down.
Ready.
Incomplete, almost picked off.
I like the scheme the defensive coordinator came up with here. They were all over the place on that play and left the quarterback nowhere to throw it.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And so it's another third down upcoming here. Gets it out of a hurry. Almost intercepted.
I thought they did a good job of reading the play and positioning themselves well to break up the pass.
Fourth and 12.
Scott is back to receive. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. They'll bring him down at the 39-yard line. The running back gets 2 on the carry.
Great play by the senior linebacker to step up in traffic and make that tackle.
Second and 8. Ball on their own 39. Side handles, makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
And he took a shot on that play, Brad. It looks like his head might be still ringing a little bit.
From their own 40-yard line, third down. The crowd at a fever pitch right now. Fires out quickly to the tailback. He's at midfield. He's knocked out of bounds at the 43.
Well played by the offensive line to sell the defense on the pass rush and then get out in front to make some room for the screen.
First and 10, ball on the 43-yard line. They bring him down for a sack on the play. We've got a flag down on the field. Might have been offside. And he helped the offense with that penalty.
And you have to be careful here because the offense will get a free play, which could become even more costly than the 5-yard penalty.
First and 5. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Coaches always say about this sophomore is that he has great lateral movement. That lets him move well behind this defensive line and get after a lot of plays in the running game.
We've got a 2nd and 5. Ball on the 38. Wallace drops to throw. Strike to his receiver. No good.
No good, the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it 35.
They'll line it up again on 3rd down. Way to look it in.
This is a quarterback who trusts his receivers, and he knows they can make plays. It's like those two were playing catch out there.
From the 28-yard line, it's 1st down. Drops back on 1st down. And he's taken down at about the 19-yard line.
You can tell he's got a lot of faith in his wide receivers. Even when he's a little bit off target, they can pull it in and make something happen.
Short yardage situation here. It's 2nd down and 1. On a counter, and down he goes at the 20-yard line. Let's throw it out to Reese now for a studio update.
The Tigers arrive today ranked number 22. We've been watching this thing all day long. And for Auburn, they're looking to win their 3rd straight.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. And he's immediately tackled.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. 1st down.
With an injury update, here's Aaron Andrews.
Thanks, Brad. The latest report is that he has a broken bone in his hand, which is a big blow to this team. But even so, he's being told to rest the remainder of the game. Brad, let's send it back upstairs to you guys in the building.
Thanks, Aaron. Going to have to find someone to step into that role for a while. I wonder who that will be. From the 16-yard line, it's 2nd down. Drops back to pass. He's under pressure. Quick throw, almost intercepted. Another 3rd down upcoming, and they've converted all 3 this drive. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. It's 4th down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Ole Miss could take the lead with this field goal. Set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep.
Number 26 sets a return.
Sends it sailing downfield. From his own goal line, He's to the 20.
That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one.
But hold on, we got a penalty on the play. Let's check it out. That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
They'll start at the 13. He's scrambling. And they make the stop, the 17-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
From their own 17-yard line, it's second down.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. The Rebels with a 3-point lead.